If you look at the myriad of things that farmers have to be, you have to have an agricultural knowledge, you have to have a botanical knowledge, a chemical knowledge, mechanical knowledge, you have to be able to market, you have to be able to deal with people, you have to have some web skills to be able to contact people in this day and age. There's so many things that are wrapped up into what being a farmer is and what it's sort of evolved to. My name is Jason Levitt, and we're on Wilsondale Farms in Owings, Maryland.
In the 4 to 5 years that we've been doing this, we've come to realize that there's really more art to this than anything else, because nothing is ever the same year to year or season to season even.
I'm Stephen Matroni.
And I'm Roxanne Matroni, and this is Nelia Matroni, and we are at 804 Cattle Company.
My name is Amanda Hand, and I'm a co-owner of Makono Farm here in Huntingtown, Maryland. I want people to realize the stewardship that's behind our pigs. We're not just throwing them in a barn and tossing feed to them every day. They are on fresh green grass. They have the ability to come and go as they please. They live really happy lives, and because of that, we put a lot of time and effort into them.
With my cattle, I can't go out there and get a hamburger or a steak off of them while they're running around the field to try it to see how it is. So I need my customers to let me know how I'm doing. And I tell them, look, if you have a problem, you're gonna be the first to know. I wanna be the second to know. We moved here in December of 1956, and I turned 5 that March. So I've pretty much been here my whole life.
We're fortunate enough to have this property, and I feel like it's my job to take care of it and improve it to the extent that I can. So my grandfather farmed here, and my mom farms here currently with me. So like I said, I'm the 4th generation, and my kids will hopefully be the 5th. The pasture-based portion of the operation, really I got interested in that by learning about Joel Salatin. He utilizes multi-species grazing, which we haven't quite achieved yet, but a lot of the tenets that he espouses as far as minimal intervention, as little synthetic chemical application, pesticide application as possible, those are all tenets that we use here now. And the key is just moving the cows to create organic matter and to keep the grass in front of them.
Science is really the foundation of everything that we do, and so we work with a lot of conservation groups, as well as extension groups, as well as the Southern Maryland Ag Development, to try to make sure that our practices are the best that they possibly can be so that we can care for our animals in the best way possible.
But what we've done though with that though is we've kind of moved people to their skill set. Roxanne, of course, being the vet, that's what she does. Me with the numbers side of thing, that's what I do.
And we're lucky to have so many skill sets within our family, quite frankly.
Southern Maryland seems to be much more interested in stewardship of the land and building up the land as opposed to degradation, you know, leaving it better than it was when you found it.
My name is Jackson Webb, and we're in Valley Lee, Maryland. The biggest positive feedback we get is that customers enjoy what they're buying. They enjoy meeting us and getting to ask those types of hard questions that we love to answer. We love to explain what we're doing and why. One of the major things we focus on with almost all the animals is movement. And so, for example, with the sheep, we'll move them once every 2 or 3 days to a fresh paddock of grass that's at the correct stage of growth. So they have access to that high quality forage. They get away from their parasites, and we encourage that growth cycle in the grass as long as we can through the year. They're followed by the egg laying chickens, which come in behind. They clean up, they scratch out any of the mess that was left. They add in their own nitrogen fertilizer, and they give us some really high quality eggs to market.
We raise Kuni Kuni pigs, which are a heritage breed from New Zealand. As we did our research, practicing rotational grazing, etc., we felt like this was the best fit for a small acreage. And it's also considered a niche breed of, We lived in Europe for 6 years, and to be able to develop some of those same meats and cuts of charcuterie here in America on my own farm that, you know, became very endeared to us in Italy and Spain has been an amazing circle. I've just loved that.
One of the most enjoyable experiences I think we've had with customers is seeing them grow to try new things that maybe we're presenting to them for the first time. It could be anything like a cut they may have never come across in a grocery store, and learning how to enhance that or make it fit in their family's life or in their own kitchen. They're excited about it. They're excited about what we're bringing, and we get to sort of see that grow.
A lot of my customers, it's almost like they've got a trust in me, you know? You've got a relationship that if it's done right and everything, it'll actually turn into a friendship. You know?
But the customers are ultimately, in my opinion, the boss. They're the ones that vote by their dollars to tell you what you're doing and if it's valuable to them.
It's really something that you do because you love it, and you love the lifestyle, you love being around the animals, and because you do love the animals. It's not because you're in it to get rich.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to, you know, teaching my grandkids to kind of take care of the farm, take care of the animals, take care of the land. I think for me that's very, very important.
Farming to me it's an honest living. You can't really get out of it what you don't put in it. So at the end of the day, when I come here and when we finish this whole process, we have an actual saleable product that someone can eat or take home and feed their family that's tangible, and it's very satisfying.